Visual arts, panubok embroidery in Philippines, and ikat fabric in Indonesia. Basic patterns in panubok embroidery in Panay, Bukidnon. Linantay is the basic panubok or embroidery pattern. The manugtubok or embroiderer can come up with different embroidery designs using the linantay or chain stitch. Linabog is a panubok designs bulak meaning flower, patterned after the flower of the labog plant that grows abundantly in the forest. Labog is a very significant in the life of Panay Bukidnon. The flowering season of labog signals the start of planting season for their kaingin, and it also reminds them that it is already January. So you can see on the monitor, that is the bulak labog or the rounded flower, and bulak putik or the triangular flower. Togi-togi is a panubok applique patch in the edge of the clothes. Its difference from giri-giri is it is not as pointed and it is copied from the dalipe or boulders in the mountains. Giri-giri is a zigzag shape, applique and embroidery commonly used as edging on their blouses. Binalagon is a panubok designs patterned after a bind or balagon that is used to tie bamboos to create a wrap. Inagsam is a pattern after a trap like thorny ferns called agsam. That is like a trap or a nesting place for snakes. Combined together, these designs are often found in the edges of female or male garments of Panay Bukidnon. Tuko-tuko is patterned after the tuko or tukod made of kawayan or bamboo poles. This tuko also is used in making akarosa, which the Panay Bukidnon farmers use in transferring their harvest from one kaingin to another. They would usually align these bamboo poles and tie them together using a balagon or a bind in order to make akarosa, which is usually pulled by a carabao. Matang punay is a panubok design patterned after the eyes of a lovely or loving bird and a pet of Humadapnon, the punay. Humadapnon is a character in the Sugidanon or epics of Central Panay. According to F. Landa Hokano, in Sulod Society, punay or literally means dove is also a powerful female deity of the mountains who is involved in the rituals for the dead. As a part of the hamwat, part of the after-death rites which takes place after the patibara, the ritual questioning of the dead during which the corpse is asked what or who caused its death, a platform is built in one of the corners of the house for punay.
Yabon, yabon, Nagawa
namin na embroidery is panubok. Mahirap din kasi masakit sa mata, masakit sa balikat, masakit sa kamay, masakit sa buli. Sabi nila, gawa namin yung authentic ba or yung hindi siya common. Sa lahat ng mga designs namin, makikita talaga siya sa paligid namin. Kagaya ng pako-pako, makikita yan sa mga gilid ng sapa. Sudlikama, skin ng python snake, sikag-sikag or fishbone, tuko-tuko, support siya ng traditional house namin doon sa bundok. Kasi yung red, isang matapang siya na kulay. Nasa dugo na talaga namin yung pagbuborda. Ginagawa namin, hindi lang sa pera, kundi maipapamana namin sa mga younger generation. Na kung mawala man kami, meron pa rin yung mga gawa namin.
Ikat Pabrik in Indonesia. Ikat Pabrik is a dyeing technique used to create a distinct style of textiles patterns and is done by resist dyeing sections of the yarns prior to weaving the pabrik. Ikat, an Indonesian word, can be the noun means cord, thread, knots, and the Finnish ikat pabrik. Or verb means to tie or to bind. Wrap ikat. The wrap version is the easiest to create. Yarns like silk, cotton, wool, or other cloths get wound on the tying frame where they are separated into bundles. Great care is taken to minimize the workload since the binding process can be quite intense. The thread bundles are folded and a basic ikat motif is bound. This is then repeated until the threads get unfolded for weaving right after the dyeing is finished. These bundles get folded over either a vertical or horizontal axis. Sometimes these bundles are drenched in wax. Web ikat. Web ikat approach utilizes resist dyeing for web yarns. The way the web yarns move in the weaving process is why intentionally established patterns are harder to achieve. To ensure the clarity of these ikat patterns, the web yarns needs to be adjusted after each time the shuttle passes through the weaves. It is possible for the skilled craftsmen to create precise web ikat. However, for example, Japanese weavers succeeded in producing accurate white and indigo web ikats that only have small design elements in the fabrics. Double ikat. This complex technique is characterized by both the wrap and web yarns are tied and dyed before being woven into a single textile. Are relatively rare because of the intensive skilled labor required to produce them. This extra time involvement means it's also the most expensive to create.